Well, traders, I'm going to finish my day with a very, very nice green day, up $36,000. Mainly, as you can see, because of Tesla. Actually, only because you see as Tesla. Because the rest of my trades were a little bit up down. I had some very nice winners like Roku, but then PLTR, PFE, and Boeing all losers. And in fact, I'm kind of stuck with another PLTR trade, which is also down right now. But so far, small loser. So I'm going to finish very nicely in green. Let's quickly go through them. The most interesting one would be Tesla, which I will discuss later. I'll start with my loser here, Boeing. I thought Boeing was overextended. I thought the airlines were overextended. I thought Boeing should come down. Boeing initially came down under 215.40 where I shorted it, but then rather quickly moved up, had my stop somewhere around here and moved out. So, you know, the whole market at that time was kind of still unknown, started moving higher. And then when the market started moving higher, and that happened, as you can see here, at around 9.52, that's what really killed my trade. Because if you go and take a look at the S&P, you will see that at that time, the market spiked up and took out my Boeing trade. So I was hoping there's going to be a failure in Boeing, hoping there's going to be failure in the airlines. I saw some weakness in the airlines. That's why I shorted Boeing. PLTR, so far two losing trades. I mean, 1.5, because the next one is not finished, actually about to be finished right now. So it's coming. And anyway, PLTR was a big gap down. The stock is down, finished now. I'm out. So you see, it just jumped down to almost $33,000 instead of 36. So still nicely in green, but went for first short in PLTR, then the second short came in here, and PLTR definitely doesn't want to be a gap and go today. So, well, it happens. Gap and go concept usually works fine. Did not work out nice today with PLTR. It did work very nicely with Roku. Roku was another nice trade. The thing is, Roku gave me some hard time. Initial move was right over here under 277.50, right here. The first move was down, then a pullback, a classic gap and go with a reversal. Initial move was nice, but then immediately it spiked up. Did not take me out because my stop was right over here over 280, which turned out to be the right calculation for a stop. And then it crashed down. Did add under 276.50, I believe that was. And turned out to be a beautiful trade, but did not hold for long. So anyway, I do have a very nice winner in Roku, $7,000, so that was nice. And now you can see that I have two losers in PLTR, which are relatively smaller because it's not a big moving stock. Also had one loser in PFE. I'm not going to discuss it here. It was kind of boring. But the most interesting one, I would say, was Boeing. Now, you heard me talk about Boeing since we started trading today. Since we started trading today, I posted up Boeing and I said, I'm going to watch this one. And I also said that my initial planned target for a long would be 555. At that time, we saw Boeing started with a gap down, coming down, a nice gap and go formation. It came down. I did not have the chance to short it here. It was too early. I did not want to participate in that. I saw what Tesla did early. I did not want to participate. I thought it was too dangerous, although, I mean, the end result was beautiful. And then it came up again and was trying to move lower. And again, the technical formation for a trend like this is definitely down. Stock is supposed to come down from here. Well, I thought if it's going to, and that's what I said in the trading room several times, if it's going to fail moving down, I am interested. No, not if it's going to, if it's going to come down, as it probably should, because it's trending lower, then I'm just going to miss a good trade, but I think it's too dangerous to take this trade. However, I was looking for a failure in Tesla. The failure in Tesla initially came here, but then it came down once more. And at that point, I was really, really interested in watching Tesla failing once more. So you see, Tesla came down, pulled back up, came down again, did not come under the lows. So the trend is not in place. tried to come higher, maybe failed, maybe now has a better chance to come down under the lows, but no, it's starting to move higher. Now, what you need to ask yourself at that point is what the S&P is doing. And here is what the S&P is doing. Look at that. The S&P was under the lows, and look at what happened at 950 exactly, and then 951 and 952. Now, I usually watch the S&P in 5-minute candles, but that was also very, very clear in 5-minute candles. But since I'm showing to you Tesla right now in 1-minute candles, look at what happened to Tesla. So right here, that's 951. 952, 53, 54, 55. Look at my trigger point, 956. So the market already moved up quite a bit. It actually moved over the highs by then. So you can see the Tesla came up with the market with a 4-minute delay or so. You look at the S&P failing to move lower, moving over the highs, spiking up like crazy. You look for Tesla to fail. Nice technical formation here. Again, I'm not in the habit of taking stocks long, which are relatively weak. But you know, it is Tesla. What's the advantage of Tesla? Everybody's watching it. If everybody's watching it, and a lot of people like me like to trade Tesla, then a technical formation in Tesla will be noticed. What happens with institutional traders? They're going long because the S&P is going long. What happens with other people who are watching the S&P moving higher? They're also thinking about going long. So definitely more buyers than Tesla than sellers. Now look at the way it happened. A very nice technical formation. I was waiting. I mentioned this several times in the trading room today. I was waiting for it to fail. Did I know that it's going to fail? Definitely not. I had no idea it's about to fail. No idea. But since it did fail, and the market was spiking higher like crazy, then you've got two nice things going on for you. Actually, three. One, very nice technical formation in Tesla. Two, people love to go long Tesla. Three, the S&P was moving higher. Four, I was down a few $1,000 and I wanted to get into green. Not really. But Tesla's technical formation here was fantastic. Really liked it, and it worked out like a charm. Several points here, and that really worked out nice. So thank you, traders, for joining us today. Another green day. Actually, what is it today? Like Wednesday, right? So I've got one huge losing day Monday, one very fine long day yesterday, and another one today. So thanks to Tesla, nicely saved. Traders, thank you very much for following. Thank you very much for being with us. If you are on YouTube, we would ask you right now, if you may, give us a thumb up. It's just one click of a button right here below that will help our channel. And if you help our channel, we'll get more people joining. And more people joining, all of us are going to make more money. Because the more people on our channel, the stronger we are. And that helps. So if you're in the market and you're joined in by thousands of traders from all around the world, that's just like being a one huge institutional trader who is helping himself. So we will have a lot of force together, and it just takes one click of a button here. Give us a thumb up. We will appreciate that. And thank you for joining, and I'll see you all tomorrow. Bye, traders.